really good lanes with Witchdoctor. You can deal with the creeps of the Enchantress, but they do go for the carry Void.
No, wait, we have seen them play mid battle rider before. It could still be an offlane Void if they wanna do that.
Offlane Void, then it's like either support Mirana or carry Mirana.
Yeah. I think usually when I pick Mirana, it's a carry Mirana, and then they have a mid one on a more like hard carry here, like an Ember Spirit.
What would you prefer? Wouldn't you prefer like just mid Mirana and then safe lane Void, off lane bad?
I think that would be really good because it makes all the lanes incredibly hard to gank for the Enchantress. Like, she won't find easy kills, for sure.
It's also good because they still have some synergy inside of the Chrono, so even if you put the Void safe lane, he's not known for a damage dealing kind of safe laner, but it's still, you have Witch Doctor Ward and Mirana, so it's fine. Going to the final bans now here. Alliance get rid of the Elder Titan. We go back to Fnatic's side. This could be the S4 hero. We anticipate Storm, maybe Puck, as plausible options here.
DK is possible too. They like to run that in the past. It's probably not the best hero here. But you know, if you want some additional lockdown, they only have the Ruby Glyph so far. And DK is always a good option. And what really surprises me about those two teams, Elder Titan always gets the last banning phase.
What's happening today? It never happened today? It was like all day yesterday, it was either banned or first two, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One game it was picked up in the second pick phase, but other than that it was always banned or picked first phase.
I think the stronger teams just able to use the hero better than other teams, especially like, I think DC is one of the best teams with the hero. Even Wings, they know how to use the hero, they know how to build a lineup around the hero. I think that's the more crucial part of picking, when you pick Elder Titan, it's not just about Elder Titan. You want to build a good lineup around physical damage, spell damage, and sometimes teams that actually run Elder Titan, they don't do that.
But they do run the position 4 Mirana.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna play like he's gonna get boots first, and he's just gonna chase the Enchantress around, make sure that she doesn't get good ganks off, and just kill her creeps with the arrows.
Yeah.
It's probably gonna be Timbersaw mid.
Yeah, most likely.
I reckon.
Timbersaw mid.
And Bedrock right often on Ohio.
I don't see any other hero. Yeah, for Alliance, there's no other hero. Like
this. Yeah. The S4 Puck.
It's a complete comfort zone for Alliance. Like, it doesn't get better than that for them.
No excuses if they lose this.
Nah, but I don't think it's good enough this game. I think their last draft was better, and this game with a worse draft, I think Fnatic is gonna be able to take the game.
Will you agree? I would agree, yeah, Fnatic for sure. Fnatic for sure. Will it be a 2-0 shutout to start day number 3? We'll find out. Let's throw it over to our casters now. It's Toby1 and Merlini.
Well, the analysts lean the way. All the Fnatic saying the draft is better, but at the same time, if you're an Alliance fan, you're probably feeling very comfortable because Alliance is feeling very comfortable. This is through and through an Alliance draft.
If I saw the drafts with other teams, I would think that the Nature's Prophet draft is a little bit weaker, but because
this line is very, very... It's something too, which I know it's kind of always been brought up in previous tournaments. As long as you feel comfortable, if you like, don't go out of the box, just play to your own strengths. Play to something which you know you can execute and execute well. Get your timings right with it. Alliance have done this time and time again with this exact draft. So they will probably feel very nice about this, but as the panel was saying, there's a lot of perks to this Fnatic draft.
I'm running through my predictions real quick. You go on. I need my compendium levels.
You were so cheap. Okay, all Ohio. He went Sticky Napalm. He can't actually firefly himself away from this one. As Ohio, the orb's gonna come in as well. Ohio can't get out. Alliance, EGM is gonna body block him. Ohio goes down in the top river. A very early level up in Sticky Napalm. No firefly. He didn't hold the point, and he pays the price.
30 seconds to battle.
Normally you'll see them hold on, but it's actually not that big a deal. I think of the death isn't, but more so they have really deep observer wards.
Yeah, they're watching the stacks, they're watching the movement to the top lane. It does help the fact that S4 was the one to get the first blood. Now he can get the top rune as well.
That's why he went with the body block. Yeah, could have just right clicked him down, but they wanted S4 to have a good game. Like with Puck nowadays, it often feels the same way as Queen of Pain. Yeah, you're gonna have a great early game, and you're gonna be involved in a lot of kills, and then it's like that one fight that you die, and after that you're like, okay, I can't do anything else. And he's picked sometimes, but just has not had that much success. This time though, he has a Life Sealer and the Nature's Prophet to always constantly fight with the Puck. So I kind of like it this game. I think it's really good versus the Phasis Void, and like the instant silence, also very good at killing Mirana, Timbersaw. Very hard for the Batrider to catch.
This is a nightmare to really stop Bulldog on the offlane. When you send the four treants down, you know you're going to get a guaranteed pull. The fact they didn't do enough damage this last treant means he can use the fourth one to block the camp. So Admiral Bulldog doesn't even need an observer ward in the bottom lane. That allows Alliance to commit both their observer wards to the northern half of the map.
And Mushi's trying his best to
drag the creep wave around to an appropriate spot.
And it looks like, yeah, he will be able to keep the wave close to his side, although Bulldog will get a free level too.
Top lane, no higher. At least he can have something against Loader, but they can both buy up sticks in just a bit. So Ohio with the Sticky Napalm Harassment's not going to do that much. And because you've got the Observe Ward over on the small stack, like, it's even that easy just to grab it. Like, S4 could move up for a rune and you could put that Batrider in a lot of peril. Admiral Bulldog always can TP off that bottom lane. Actually holding his skill point at the moment. So hasn't decided if he needs Sprout or a TP.
Enough. No clarities though. We usually see clarities instead of Brant.
Yeah, normally you have a couple of clarities just so you have the ability to summon more trains, but at this point, I'm wondering what he's thinking.
You won't be able to jungle.
Double, Batrider, you do not have Firefly again, and that's three stomps, denying the Mud Golems, gives another one. It's just never-ending stuns from Arcade, Ohio, there's another stun with a Fade Bolt, Enchantress will find the kill. Black was saying he was looking for the Mirana to rotate around and be a real nuisance for RK, but so far RK has had free reign of his jungle, and again they catch out this Batrider.
He just needs level 2, or just having Firefly, but now he's died twice because he hasn't had Firefly. RK's even stolen his large centaur from that camp, so he can't really get an easy level 2 from there. Now, he's gonna go back to the jungle, but 2 minutes in and there's still level 1.
He's gonna leech it from mid. This is his only way to do it. He can leech it from mid, now gets his level 2. There is a semi-stack. There's like Hell Bears and the two small Wild Wings available. So he can farm this up and that'll bring him up to close to level 3.
It's still a disaster though. Arke
mid lane, the smoke maneuver, the first stuns arrive, another Mud Golem stun, S4 with the extra silence, Timbersaw dropping low, but he's still got 10 reactive armor charges up. So this dive from Alliance pushes the Timbersaw off the lane with no bottle charges.
Wow, he was really close to getting that kill. He tried to time the death of the Rock Golem to get an additional 2 stuns out on mid one.
They're going again. There's no Timbersaw available for the first stun. Into the clap with the Orb Bulldog. He TP's in. The Courier is nearby as well. The damage from S4 is not enough. And now we're higher. He's sticking napalm. He's got his Firefly. He's looking towards S4. The arrow will fly. S4 waits it out perfectly for the paralyzing cut for 343. He'll go down. Arcade's army still exists. They cannot have enough damage to find the kill. Even the Maledict on Admiral Bulldog. Not enough tick damage there.
Arcade very well known for his Shen as well as Enchantress. But Alliance 4 kills up already. And he's not going to have that many smokes available to him, but he's already done the damage. Ohio is still reeling from this disastrous early game.
Hey, you called it perfectly. Dakota asks the question at the end of game number 1, how do you want to see it change? Like, I was looking for a jungler, and you asked for someone who's got a little bit more activity early on, and the intent is exactly that.
And heroes that they like. Can't particularly imagine Bulldog liking playing Tyrander.
Does love that MP.
Now we have double phase boosts. So phase boost for Loader, phase boost for Bulldog, they TP up to the top lane, and they're looking to force down the tier 1 tower. Knowing how much they've crippled the Batrider, there should be no defense to this. Ohio right now is just trying to take a triple stack inside of his own jungle. So an early free tower for Alliance.
And it looks like Mushu will be the one to come up here.
Pick up, open wounds. They're just chipping him a little bit, just so he can't time walk off the damage straight away.
He saw all his regen. He wasn't really pressured too much by Bulldog, so he sets the tangos, won't heal himself, he'll be a-okay, and that's a good way to save your first tower and buy some more time for Ohio.
They're really looking for even more time. Like, it's a triple phase boost now from Alliance. One is just not enough, two is not enough. RK will grab them. Is this kind of like what you're looking for from RK to get early phase boosts instead of getting something more like the Arcanes?
I think that's the game plan. They want to fight a lot with the MP. Constantly look for opportunity.
Try and chase DJ down bottom lane. Admiral Bulldog will come in too. They're waiting for the leap, but then Bulldog will pull up to the scrap. 3-4-3 on the other side of the tree line. Paralyzing cast. Maledict is over on Nature's Prophet. Ohio trying to close the distance, but RK still in the neighborhood. And Chan comes back off cooldown for him.
We could have had the slow if required. Even with some lucky bounces, Fnatic cannot get on the board yet.
Still find a lot of CS. Faces Floyd with 36-9. Timbersaw able to grab 31 CS early on. So on that front, Alliance aren't doing that terrific. They're ahead. They were ahead by 2k at one point. The game is still fairly close.
Alliance can easily get out of control though. Puck's already level 6. NP. He can be anywhere, wherever Enchantress wants the NP to be. And on top of that, Enchantress has been very involved, involved in all 4 kills, but he's already level 5 on the Ench, so he's not really suffering in terms of experience.
I am seeing the recovery of the Batrider. Like, Ohio is getting himself back into a position where he's got more net worth than Nature's Prophet. He's definitely got more levels than Nature's Prophet.
It was really important that Lucy TP'd up there to stop that push. They have like okay pushing heroes with NP, but he doesn't have Cecilius. Lifesteal are not the best at hitting towers, especially without a Blight Stone. So that tower should not have fallen. A lot of stacking going on the Fnatic side. Any heroes that can take it out? Rana also getting decent amounts of farm and levels level 5 with Arcane.
Oh, we have an Infest combo for the first time. Loader straight into S4. Probably hoping the mid one's going to get aggressive. Mid one's been fairly aggressive against S4, actually forcing S4 to go back to base a couple of times. But now Brimcoil, they open up. Where's the silence? Where's the control? The Timber takes the last. Is also coming in to knock some damage and the chain away. It'll hurt S4 and Loader, but it hurts mid one more as he will fall. And Bulldog instantly TPs down the bottom lane. Doesn't want to give DJ any space to push the lane.
Did he have a TP throw before? I wasn't really sure on this Timber.
Unknown. Bushi, jump, chrono, two men available. If he wanted it, but without 343's death ward, he knows he doesn't have the damage to kill off S4. Just can dissuade Alliance from again pushing a T1 tower.
Pray for some bashes. Oh, a lot of bashes. They get 2 points up the sidewalk at least.
Nice sentry ward down for 343, so they'll get both the Obs and the sentry that RK planted a couple of minutes ago.
EJ already level 6. The Rubick closing in on it as he farms the top lane, so all these supports are about to be able to fight back.
Nice ult from Fnatic in the top river. Counting out the fact that's almost a full duration ward as well in the top river. But it's all loaded moving up. Mid one's already there to defend. Mushi is able to move up as well.
Alliance are just trying to get a feel for how Fnatic's gonna play. Are they gonna try and use the Faceless Void like aggressively and set up, or are they gonna try and use it reactively to TP the towers? Are they gonna be sitting behind people with the Mirana trying to arrow people, or is she gonna be trying to farm up the jungle with Arcanes? They're still not exactly sure how Fnatic are gonna respond to these early threats, but now we see the large scale engagement about to brew on top.
Comes Alliance. One defense, 343, still no level 6 on him. Alliance is waiting just long enough, but Arcane does have his Impetus, so the damage is there. Moonlight Shadow, Avril Bulldog looks like he's the primary target on bottom lane. Ohio could just walk up to him and grab that last two of Bulldog. There's not much he can do about it. He is a little bit tanky, but now with the Starfall, Avril Bulldog falling, not dead yet. Let's grab the Major Guard. That's held the top lane, where you currently have the corner. Mushi picked up and rolled back down again by Rubick. For Solus actually holding Witch Doctor and Ohio back on the tier 1 tower, allowing him to kill off now the Witch Doctor. Just took a fall, S4 hit by the arrow of DJ. Loader has to pop out of him. A little bit of Infest damage, but Mushi standing ground looking for the time lock. Will actually take off a little bit of the damage thanks Radiant's to that time walk of his. Fancy to back out of here. DJ with a star fall. Doesn't get the extra star on the Loader. Then a 20 HP. RK will turn with the damage. He had enough mana for one Impetus. Then a stick charge back up again. But that was enough to dissuade again DJ from chasing Alliance.
I really like that play from Fnatic where they went for the weakest target, the Nature's Prophet, who's not quite with his team. Alliance tried to get a little bit greedy and squeeze a little bit more farm out of Admiral Bulldog before that T1, but they got punished for it. And now I think Ohio has more than recovered from his early two deaths.
Ohio's back where he wants to be. Maybe not all the way where he wants to be. Wants to have that Blink Dagger up, but being only 200 net worth behind Admiral Bulldog.
They still have Chronos here on Rubick. Assault last night using like two heroes, like you called out, but they can set up for another kill within 1 minute's time. I guess they don't have the best hero. Enchantress can be
cool. There.
Yeah.
Radiant's
that's probably the best
combo
for him.
Stealing Time Dilation is also really good too, if he can manage to get his hands on that.
His AGM's Rubick. He learned something, he can get his nothing moves. That was an aggressive jump forward. He's gonna lose his life here. He came down just for the room, but he time walked himself in. It might be level 4 with a 6-second cooldown, but Alliance, they only needed 5 seconds for that.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
That was aggressive. Maybe cutting down the tree so that he could get a little bit more vision of those two heroes, but maybe thinking that Alliance is not going to play aggressively, but they've built all aggressive early items, like no Midas on Bulldog, we see the maze onto the Enchantress, so you know that Alliance are just going to fight, not farm.
So that T1 town dropping on the top lane in favor of Loda, that armor coming up quicker. Alliance's teamfight getting better, now Bulldog comes to the mid lane.
They're missing a quite light shot on Alliance. I think it really helps the tower.
Up from the room, it's got the Batwaddle, it drops double sentries here. There's no way to hide the Moonlight Shadow. A little bit of waste of money with the sentries, but they take the kill and the tier 1 tower. And they didn't even need to bring Loda. Loda is still on that top lane farming up. Maybe not the greatest thing when Faceless Void is staring him down, but he's got no friends around to help find the kill.
This is just a lineup that Alliance loves to run. When you can take away a lot of your mental power from execution on the hero, because you've played the hero hundreds and hundreds of times, you can much better plays around the map, farm a lot more efficiently, and you also like know when and where your teammates are going to be.
But this is also the other reason why the tier 1 town's dropping. It's the standard play, give Bulldog the space to be profit.
Now, Pluck closing in on his Blink Dagger. Find that with Lifestealer, Nature's Prophet, no one's safe on the map.
It's a really good teamfight, really good jump. Also gonna give Mushi Dyer's something to think about. Like, he's gonna go for this early Vlad's build, but he may have to consider going in for a Manta to break free of the silence.
Yeah, I think a more common choice is Diffusal. This is a bit cheaper, and it offers still pretty good damage inside the Chronosphere. And you can help your teammates out just in case, and then you can just time walk out of the Dream Coil. Are fortified.
Both teams are needing some free hits on the safe lane tier 1. Loda's moving just a little bit quicker on it with the help of Admiral Bulldog.
I actually really don't think Vlad is the build here.
Could just be a reaction to the fact that Alliance want to try and team fight.
But there's not really any heroes
Lifesteal. He's gonna love this. He's still got Time Warp stolen, so he repairs all the damage. Has 4 turns. He's looking for the Dream Coil. He'd prefer to get both of them. But he'll set a full chip, settle for just a Timber Sword. Bulldog will TP himself in too. And they had a Loda just waiting, sitting inside. 3-4-3 starts his TP. There's no extra stun to stop that. In fact, now they TP the top lane, Mushi. Does he go make a break for the tree line? TP scrolls available. Yeah, he does. He jumps over. And again, no stuns available. So TPR successful. As 2 T1 towers also taken, one for each side.
Uh-oh, Rubik's almost as far into the Timbersaw. He's just a couple hundred net worth, and EGM almost has Blink Dagger.
EGM Rubick. There's a reason why this hero a couple of years ago was taken off the mid lane and put into a support role. And EGM was one of the catalysts for that.
Something also like expanded versus Alliance.
EGM, that's a fresh ops. Now they try Sentry Mushi. Time walks in, more of a zoning style, but it's actually Arcade. But all Ogre Frostmage that does the rest of the deep warding.
Dyer's bottom
so at least they get rid of the orbs.
A Fnatic can't feel safe farming anywhere though. Like all these heroes can just easily die to the Infest Bomb from Puck or even an Infest Bomb from the Nature's Prophet. Batrider with the Blink Dagger, maybe they can put some moves onto Alliance. They need to get a kill. Bulldog is probably the easiest target for them to kill.
Especially when he's not going for that Blink Dagger style.
Yeah.
But he's still fairly tanky.
He's also farming in the same place. He's off the map. He's in the jungle. And they know when to show the heroes that are very unlikely to die. Like Loda's out in front. He's kind of hovering around that mid lane. Puck's also a pretty decent target to show in the lane.
They know. Like Fnatic know that Alliance are coming over, so they just smoke underneath the Dire of Circle off the jump forward. They kill him. The Chemical qualifies again. And what goes in a 3-man fire! The power steps on the engine and now Corner! A 3-man without 1-2! Mushi, the Sprout! It keeps him far away! EGM can time walk off the damage! DJ makes a break for the trees, but Alliance, they haven't lost a single iota. Finally, the puck will pop as the Maledict that does the work.
They looked prepared for it, but they didn't have Mushi there. Mushi needs to be the one to stop them with the Chrono Spear. And without the Witch Doctor alive, they just did not have enough damage. That was a great Chrono Spear. So they jump on to Timbersaw. He's blown up. Where's Mushi?
Still not there. The TP is in, only just arrives. But everyone's the Chrono is great, but everything's done.
They've got caught by the Chrono Spear or by the Dream Coil. Admiral Bulldog's already on the top. He catches his ultimate, and the two heroes in the back just already died. And the fight's lost in there once you just lose mid one without getting anything really in return.
And I want to give even more props to Bulldog for that Sprout. Actually, in the middle of a Chrono Spear, keeping the Faceless Void between like his prey, getting in between his prey. And EGM is such a nuisance. Now they go for the bottom lane again. There's TP support in the neighborhood, S4's here. And you have that Blink Dagger on EGM now. He has a stolen Starfall.
And now they don't even need a gank anymore. They have
Blink, pick him up, EGM, throwing back in again. They knew the Timber Chain was coming. RK wasn't close enough for the stun, but still a blue. Now the Dream Call, mid one! It is just looking too easy for Alliance, but it's good vision. Fnatic look for it with the Sentry Wall, but they missed the obs.
They can easily be roasted now. Level 3 untouchable on Enchantress, Blightstone, and Echo up on Lifestealer. This is going to be a super easy roast. And Fnatic can find a few minutes to farm, but when it comes to teamfight, how are they actually going to protect someone from dying instantly to the Lifestealer? Where are their force tabs?
Dire's top tower is under attack.
They don't have anything. Like, come on, Witch Doctor's just dreamy. He could have like arcanes or some other normal item apart from a wand. Probably just happy hit level 6.
They need more picks with the
item. Through my shadow.
Well, there's the 30 for EGM right in the neighborhood. And Ohio will drop EGM. Gets the last hit.
Yeah, too predictable, but that's like the only thing they've really been doing is trying to get killed with the Batrider. They also have Chronosphere plus Witch Doctor ulti available to them, but Mushi's been far more concerned firing his secondary item after the Vlad.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Or even like Void with Piranha be a pretty good combination for them.
Once DJ does have that Ag, then maybe you have the damage, but still requires the Miranda to be in a good spot.
Pretty close. Be West. Now you have Nathan Prophet almost with Orchid. So Timber is going to have a really rough time. You want your Yules by the time that the Orchid comes out. But he's not even going to have Bloodstone. He bought his cloak because he was on the
one. Starts the TP, comes too far away. And no Bastion on Loader yet. A very easy TP out. Diffusal Blade is done for Mushi, who now actually gets silence. Decides to hold on to his Diffusal Charge. Just S4. I don't know if he's just trying to bait out of the fusel charge, in fact.
Radiance middle
tower. Be careful. They can actually turn around with Chrono. Is Puck actually going for an Orchid as well? I don't see that very often.
All silences.
Yeah, it's great versus Faceless Void, although he does have Confusal.
Yeah.
Two Orchid.
But he's going to burn the charges so quickly. That's why I thought like S4 was baiting out a charge on him just then. It's like, well, you expect the rest of the Alliance to be right behind S4. Ags gets done now for the Miranda, 19 minutes on the support. Bad timing, but this EGM in the mid lane. They're looking towards Mushi. EGM jumps in, picks up Mushi. They're throwing the tower, they time walk, he gets the Chronosphere off. Mushi now time walked off a little bit of damage, but he's more importantly keeping away. But Ohio, he can't do it. 3-4-3, the Death Ward goes to work. EGM was looking for the steal. Couldn't find it. 3-4-3, the damage will be enough. It's a 1-for-1 trade-off. On the cleanest fight for Alliance, but Fnatic finally getting something. A fourth kill in the game.
S4 tried to go for the plus one, blinking in the back line and coiling people so they could pick him off as Faceless Void retreated from battle. Back. They weren't really concerned with saving Amushi, and all four of them were there trying to kill the Puck. It's been a struggle to try and find good builds for the Puck. A lot of the Puck's builds bail very early on. Not that great with their lineup.
Unless you go like Veil Dagon to go against the Timber.
Yeah, maybe Vieta Morana, but Veil Dagon requires a lot of farm and it's still, I would think, falls off a little bit. So maybe he's just looking for another way to scale into the late game. I think like getting a Bloodstone probably would be pretty good. Might click very, very hard.
forward from RK, but it was easily scouted out thanks to the Observer and Sentry on the hillside. There's RK. Oh man, even denying his own Observer one. Fnatic can't catch a break. And the push comes again from Alliance, the tier 2 tower. The second remaining out of town for Fnatic. That's a big army for Fnatic to try and clean up. Chakram won't do that much.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
All of Fnatic's heroes just feel fairly useless. Like in terms of their teamfight prowess, like
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Both of their abilities have just been used to
top. AP from top, Bulldog, he's got an invested loader inside him. And then they just attack it as he stays. The Orca goes to work. He looked for a good carrier. The Puck was the first one for the life stealer. Now it's actually Puck is in trouble. Last dude up. Urushi's looking for the time lock. Heads fall. Spaceship can he get himself out this one? There's no ult. He can't blink away in time. And that is going to be Puck down for a long time and a good bit of money in for Void.
Puck's actually died 4 of the 5 times that Alliance have perished this game. I don't know. I don't know if Oblivion Staff was a build. Maybe it's going to work out for him later on, but
instead of getting something like a Yule Sept to make it a lot more difficult to kill him.
Yule's is way more common versus the Faceless Void. You need to get rid of that time leech. If you can't face it the second time, like, the hero is high because he doesn't have that much armor, very little HP. You completely rely on your spells and your items to get you out of trouble.
See, in the Goldcraft, there's still a lot of money going the way of Alliance, so maybe he can still afford up the Yule Scepter. I don't know if you want to leave a casual Oblivion Staff on the Puck.
You could technically turn into Echo Saber, I guess. It's not like you're investing any gold in the recipe, so you still get the mana regen, the int, the attack speed, and the strength, more importantly. But yeah, I don't think that's what you do, but you know, if you don't want to build an Orchid and realize the error of your ways.
You can always just sell this Null Talisman, get the Yule Scepter, and then get the Orchid later.
You still want an Orchid though?
Oh, when you got a Tempestor on the field, it's not going to throw the BKB.
Yeah.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
It would make sense.
He'll probably look to... maybe Lotus?
Timber, Prince Fire, S4, cancelling mid 1's TP. Support's on the way from both Fnatic and Alliance. It's Nature's Prophet done for with Moonlight Center, the Green Glasser. They focus on Prophet, Bulldog, the arrow will connect as well from DJ. And this is Alliance. Losing players, they don't really need to lose. S4 locked in the tree line, still no TP's scroll available. They'll have to walk it out. Spaceship falls up in 1 second time. DJ waits for the moment. And well, Batrider Firefly will take the moment from him.
Ooh, and that's rough. He's fighting just before level 14. And level 14 is actually a really important level on Puck because you need that level 4 phase shift so you can phase and then blink. He only had 2.25 seconds left.
GM? Mid one doesn't have a TP scroll. He has to stay here. EGM, he knows something is wrong and they're gonna find him in the tree line. And that is now the 5th kill for Loda. So while Puck has been dying, Bulldog, couple of casualties as well. In fact, just between all of like Fnatic's kills, it's only on Bulldog and S4. Loda is having a terrific time.
But you can see the gold graph starting to swing up. One of the worries as you play with a Puck on your team. Is he gonna fall off 20 plus? And or even more worrisome if they get BKB.
Chrono, they find Loda. Loda, he needs time. This Chrono needs to end for him, but he can't do it. Loda will drop. It's a huge kill for the Batrider. Take S4 with a Dream Soul. They hold Ohio, not Mushi, however. He's the Time Walk himself out. So it's going to be Ohio picked up by the EPM. With a Dolan Time Walk, he can track down the Batrider.
Rubik is making so many plays in this game. EGM. What a beast. Maybe he can carry.
He's building Aghanims. Yeah. This is an Aghanim TGM rush off the Blink Dagger.
Imagine if he steals Death Ward. The Dream Coil.
And if he steals Death Ward though, that's kind of on 3-4-3.
I mean, he's just sitting there channeling.
But then again, actually, you don't want to...
We could talk with a Voodoo Restoration.
He hasn't skilled it. Yeah. There's not a single point in it, so technically at the moment, he can.
A lot of times you're just like not, you're more worried about your placement, you don't want to get caught in Chronosphere, you want to be like close enough so you can follow up. So it's something that's easily can slip out of your mind, especially because Rubik's not a super common support pick nowadays. Bushi closing in on his core, the Yasha, Manta, so many ways out of
the hit of killing GM.
Okay, what is S4 gonna go for? He's back in base right now, is he gonna spend 2,000 gold, could kind of complete his Orchid, or he could sell his Null and almost get his Yule. I'm not sure what his mindset is here. or what he wants to do. I think he's dying a lot, so I think he needs a different idea.
You'll find out sooner or later, man. That was a weird move from Fnatic. They Moonlight Shadowed while Witch Doctor was de-warding an Observer Ward of Alliance. So Alliance had perfect vision of what was going on, they know Moonlight Shadow was down. And they infest Lifestealer into the park, EGM is the front runner.
Midwar doesn't really have an escape plan. Ohio does, it looked like he was flying instead of more smoke and
they find Rinky. Observer Ward's down, they jump, they pick him, they control him.
The darkness.
Perfect movement from Alliance, and now they're 60 seconds without a Faceless Void.
Yeah, he thought his Manta Illusion would keep him safe, but Zenimax too, they definitely know that they're illusions. And he also was way too close to the tree line on that right side.
Advantage for Fnatic is the creep waves were all pushed out. So even if Alliance did want to take down that tier 2 tower with this 1 minute downtime of the Void, they're just not capable of doing so. Even their bottom lane is being pressured. Bulldog has a couple of trees down there, but he's not committing himself.
Ooh, DJ actually has a gem. Thinks that this is their time to get back into the game, maybe stop that second Roach coming out from them.
Maybe they're also just worried about all this vision of Alliance, seeing where they're maneuvering.
Yeah, but he could easily die. Like, and if that's not for Puck, like, there's no way out for Puck or for the Murana at that point.
Doesn't seem like there's any way out for anyone apart from maybe a Timber or a Time Warp, that's it. And here they come, boys up in 4 seconds time to jump in, they find Arcane, drag him up on top of the hill. Is there any save? No, there is not. In fact, now it's the Infest, pop out, mid one floor, reaching for a chrono target. The only one he's going to find is the Puck, who then actually has an Infest rune. S4 taking a little bit too much damage from the Maladic, so he's going to pop from that with a phase shift timing. He'll survive through it. Load up, will it be enough for the chrono? They hold him in position, they actually do. It is still enough. From the Maladic to kill off the Puck. Lifestealer drops two, and they're all on the run. EGM, Bulldog, Confuser Blade, slows him down, but he already has a Hurricane Pike freshly delivered. Give him that movement away, but the Flame Breaker down. Another Confuser Charge, slowing him up, and Bulldog will die. Fnatic getting big back-to-back kills against Alliance. And this will repair all of the negative XP they were behind in. It may even bring the gold down to being practically level.
Yeah, and most of Fnatic heroes have fought items before. They've died first Timber with like a cloak and a cloak incomplete. I saw Murana by a Ghost Scepter before she died. Faceless Void had a Manta style before he got picked up on top. And looks like Puck has completed his Orchid, so he went for it. Yep.
Still seems like a huge danger zone for Alliance. They had such a good start on this 10,000 advantage in the gold, and they were getting kills left, right, and center. Fnatic couldn't find anything. The Lifestealer had free reign. But now Fnatic have just, they're getting really good chain kills.
I think they kind of were in the mindset that, okay, well, they're not going to really play aggressively on us. We've counter-ganked a couple of times, like they countered a Batrider on the top lane. They dealt with multiple Void Chronospheres, and they felt comfortable enough to farm, because that's what Alliance likes to do. But Fnatic, they were not stopping, they weren't scared of the Infest Bomb. So the Alliance may be able to secure the kill of Roche Fnatic, nowhere close to the pit.
Yeah, they're too far away and down. Yeah,
there's no way for them.
Yeah, the damage from Alliance are also quick enough, they'll get through Roche.
So a lot of times they actually give it to Bulldog, but maybe they give it to Loda this time?
Protecting Loda seems to make a little bit more sense. That allows him to safely farm up, maybe even purchase his full assault Kuros, which looks to be his next target.
Yeah, then he can actually go in and bait the Chronosphere. That fight, he actually had to back off very early on because he was scared of being in that bubble.
Oh, S4, he just blinked forward, just used his orb as well. Smoke maneuver from Fnatic, but it's kind of a weird one. They ran one down mid, they pushed two to north and two to south.
Oh, this is
and now
pretty interesting. If they show someone on top, then they're going to all think they're near bottom. But Alliance actually returned with a smoke of their own.
Yeah, and they pinged out exactly where mid one was moving. They actually pinged it towards mid lane. But if they follow down inside the jungle, S4 is going to get an easy pick on mid one. He's got 15 plus for charges. Denial is possible. Holy crap, Tipper Chain! No Bloodstone charges. Well, he loses five of them. But no Bloodstone denial.
Ohio and Murana springing a trap on top lane. Will Bulldog or anyone else TP up there?
A Bulldog just TP'd himself to the mid lane. They're coming for Arax. You got the range on the Prophet.
Got a lifesteal who's just itching to be into a building. Oh, okay, maybe the puck will come up, but DJ revealed himself.
It's a crap, though.
Oh, the jump. No higher. Secondary TP's on the way. The last two net four, and he survived. The Orca was on DJ. Bulldog is on his way in. Now the Orca's on higher. Ohio still has that advantage of flying. Oh, DJ hides in the tree line. Another phase shift from S4. Wants the ball up too far away. He'll join in, then blink forward. But it's EGM who finds the kill with the Starstorm. And with that arrow flying from Arana, you actually reveal your position. DJ leaps up, and then TP's away to safety.
I silence from Puck. They weren't able to get like all the bursts down during the last. So ideally, like the Puck just farms the lane and doesn't actually jump, so you can get the lasso on him before he casts anything. Like Puck was expecting it.
Here comes Alliance. No Batrider for 30 seconds. Buyback is unavailable. They can chip away at the base. Timber is also on bottom lane trying to push this out, but in the meantime, Alliance now arrived on the top. Timber needs to be here for the shotgun. Slows down the push, but doesn't really stop Loader. He just rages through it, the paralyzing cast, wait, oh the arrow! It hit S4, that's a good 5 seconds. You do still have the lifesteal inside of an S4. He'll run quickly, moves the chronosphere. EGM and Arcane caught the back line. The Sharkram as well is ripping through Arcane bit by bit, but they need more damage. The mounting will help with that one. EGM trying to juke at everything he stopped, but he already used the leap. Two heroes lost from Alliance. No higher was more play break to bubble. There's no Arcane Seekman. He's on Bulldog, and they will hold and win the last two. Fnatic fend against Alliance. Very aggressively pushing in to that tier 3 tower. And they pay the price.
Not S4's best game. That was one of the worst times to get hit by an arrow. Loader is walking very close to the Fnatic lineup.
That's Fnatic. Easy push to tier 2. Another bad fight for Alliance.
Mushi, I think, had a really patient Chronosphere.
He got the Rubik so that he can't just steal it and then Chrono his entire team. A little bit slow with killing him, but still with the right idea.
That's still the perfect start as well. Get that quick look at it. There's that arrow on the S4. The death ward from very, like, the best safety point for 343. And Load had the tank through all of it. Once you mop up the back lines, you're pretty good. We come back live as the Infest. Pop back out again, it's Mushi as well as mid one on the run. DJ is low, this is Alliance, they need to take this fight for the time loss from Mushi. Holding Loader in position, you can time walk down again, get him safety in Moonlight Shadow, Prophet TP forward. The vision, the sentry ward is down, the Sprout holds him, but the arrow flies through, doesn't find a target, the BKB Batrider on the front lines, can't get the last two off, he doesn't actually have a real target to go for. S4 will not jump any further. He knows the BKBs are down. But where is your target? The ping came out. They saw 343 in the tree line. Just to the right, that's where Lifestealer will go. The arrow comes in again. It goes away from the Alliance heroes. Unable to connect, and now that's Witchdoctor down for a little bit.
Looked like they were about to retreat, but Timbersaw canceled his TP, realizing that perhaps Chronosphere could have swung that fight for Fnatic. However, he didn't really have enough mana to Manta and Time Walk and use Time Dilation and Chronosphere. That's why I kind of like the Echo Saber build from Faceless Void. He's a little bit more mana regen than the Vlads, and you can farm and fight, especially if you're a position 1 Void. She's been playing pretty well.
As long as he gets the Chrono, it seems the rest of his team can do the work. And with an E-Blade up on DJ, more burst damage potential from Fnatic. I sent the Blink Dagger up at the moment, but Batrider, Fireflying, looking for an opening. The Treant from Bulldog is so close, and the arrow will actually tank on the Treant. This gives just a warning to S4. He'll back up a little bit from the top lane. And EGM is now doing the split push on bottom. He's got Time Walk available with Blink Dagger and a TP. They actually scan to see if anyone from Fnatic has come out, and they are not.
He actually has Ags this time. Last time, I think he had Ags, but wasn't able to steal anything aside from the leap from Mirana. But yeah, a lot of great spells to steal. Get the passive Starfall, you steal Starstorm? I don't know.
Very good question. Technically, you think it should work. EGM. Oh, Batrider! at the same time as UGM went for the telekinesis, he wants to time walk off the damage, able to do so. BKB triggered from Ohio, they really want to kill off EGM, but it was Whisper from the backline that got the kill. Now Mushi does fall, but needs the time with the ball over the corner. It got loaded and pulled off, and for Dream Pop, he's trying to cause a couple of problems. Ohio is dropping down low on EGM, almost soloing up DJ, and he will. He'll blink up and find that kill. There's the rest of damage being done by Mushi. He'll find that kill on Loader, the big hero of Alliance. Top net worth, but it's still a 3-for-2 trade-off. No Witch Doctor early on, but we're still able to get that kill on Batrider. And the plays from EGM, the man being initiated on, able to track down the Mirana.
I think you're okay with that, Dear Fnatic. He got the two big cores, the Lifestealer and the Nature's Prophet inside of that Chronosphere. And as long as they die, your Timbersaw didn't die, it's still a little close, I guess. Losing Mirana is a pretty big deal considering he has an Ethereal Blade at this point. What on earth?
Yep, it's the money, man. E-Blade, that's the pop I was talking about. And the damage, which is still there as well for Alliance, it's going to start to increase. Arcane, now 50 gold away from having his Aghanim Scepter, combining with the Dragon Lance.
Yeah, they have a Lotus Orb on Timbersaw, so they have so many ways to get out of the silence on the Fnatic, especially if Face of Void replenishes his Arcane charges.
Timber's going to find him in Viz Rune. They just walk over. The Faceless Void's the neighborhood, Sentry Ward Arcane. He thought something was awry. He popped the Sentry Ward down, now Bulldog TP's in. Do they have a control? No, they don't. And they know the Mushi's around, there's no Chronosphere available. But there are 8 fresh Diffusal Charges on that Faceless Void. He's now got the level 2 Diffusal Blade.
Another position 4 scaling well as we see Arcane complete 4 items, Dragon Lance and Ags. Not too many great targets, though. Timbersaw normally, like, either really close or too far. Faceless Void can time walk most of the damage. And Manta might be very difficult for a single target hero like Enchantress to dish out the damage.
Nice blink that too, and more falling back. The health blows on the way, the phase shift is there. Apple pulled over the corner, and guarantees the kill on S4 as he comes out of his phase shift. The arrow won't get into him, but down for the way, we're ripping through Loader. He'll invest into that one little radio grip, pop back out again, but it doesn't get him far enough away. Two heroes down for Alliance, both without buyback. Fnatic have an opportunity here. They can push through the bottom lane and do some damage to the base.
What another great Chronosphere coming out from Mushi. Did not hesitate at all. S4 is really important to them at this point. Catching Lifestealer, especially during Rage, so important.
Mushi time walks forward, EGMs.
Yeah, he has Star Thorns.
Yeah,
I can actually see him.
Yeah. I think he actually tried to do it then. Like, he ran forward. Now, Arcane! A big hit! This could be it for Fnatic. Getting that pop, the E-Blade. Helps to get the kill for Timbersaw. But with another hero down, Arcane down for a minute, it may not just be one lane of Rax. He may be looking at 2 lanes of Rax, and now they find Bulldog. There's a great Rax here from Ohio. Admiral Bulldog shredded up, and he'll pop to the Maledict. Nothing was going to stop that. Alliance losing too many heroes. The former TI winners are staring down the barrel of a 2-0 elimination by Fnatic.
Buck has the next item. Will be a BKB to complement the Orchid. But at this point, it's too little too late as Fnatic looks to claim another lane.
Dire's middle tower has fallen. There's your smoke. What are you going to do with this?
They need to fight before the Chrono's up.
Rubik gets the pick up. Try and drag mid one back. The jump in. Mushi time walks up all the damage to the Lion Sith. The Dream Call wants to control it. And with a Lotus Orb on Mushi, he's so safe. Bulldog also shot up with the arrow connect to the Chrono. All the remaining players Alliance. How do you get yourself out of this one? You can all over it. EGM will time walk up the damage, but Mushi time walks right back with him. There's your Star Ball damage. Alliance, back to power. But no time to save on this map. Fnatic, they own your home. And Alliance, 2 lanes of Rax down. The only thing that protects them is that TQ tower on top lane. But at this point, Fnatic can push for GG. Everyone's dead. No buybacks available.
This tournament has been a sad state of affairs for those a fan of the European teams, as another one looks to fight with us.
Alliance, you hope for it. Even okay, I like the death though, pick up on 3-4-3. Just the glory, a little bit of extra negative armor to bring down these buildings, but there it is. GG, well played. Fnatic have done it. They will start off as 8 with a 2-0 over Alliance, eliminating the Romney International 2016.
Mushi was so clutch in the later half of the game with this Chronospheres just and that unlucky arrow catch as Alliance were in a position of power, kind of push that high ground.
It looked like such a good start though for Alliance. Like, you get that first blood, you shut down the Batrider, but then space just seemed to be created. The pressure didn't really come. A couple of T1 towers went down, but the Batrider found his items, he found his timing, and he found his progression.